Hey everyone, Marin here for Learn Fun. Thanks for joining me today. Last time I took you to Hawaii to have a refreshing strawberry cocktail at a tiki bar. Well, this time we're still in Hawaii and we're surrounded by some gorgeous hibiscus flowers and tropical leaves. So the flowers are from the happy hibiscus dicet. The leaves are from the tropical leaves dicet. I used the aloha die to create my sentiment, the flamingo together coordinating dies to create flamingo silhouettes, and for the background, I used the tropical leaves background stencils. I started with the background and cut an 8.5 by 3.5 slimline panel out of mermaid cardstock. And as I just said, I used the tropical leaves background stencils to create a beautiful leafy background. I taped my panel to my glass surface using washi tape, then taped the stencil with the largest leaves on one side. And to protect the other side from any inky mess, I just placed a piece of scrap paper between the stencil and the panel. And then I applied white pigment ink on the stencil. I got the idea from Mindy Egan from the design team. She used white ink first on one of her latest cards and I loved the result. So I decided to give it a try. So thank you so much, Mindy, for the inspiration. So I applied a first coat of white ink. And because my choice of cardstock was pretty light, I decided to add two more coats of ink just to make the color more opaque. And I let the ink dry between each coat. I let it really soak into the paper. It helped a lot to make the color more vibrant. I let the ink dry, cleaned up my stencil, and repositioned it at the same place, right on the leaves. And then I shifted that stencil just 1 or 2 centimeters towards the bottom right on my panel. I taped the stencil and the scrap paper and picked 2 shades of blue oxide inks, tumble glass and peacock feathers. I first applied a coat of tumble glass all over the stencil just to get a nice base. Next, I added a little bit of peacock feathers here and there. I did it pretty randomly. And then I used my tumble glass blending tool to mix the colors nicely. I removed the stencil and here you can see that the white leaves bring more depth, like 3D leaves, to my background. Next, I needed to fill the empty spaces between the leaves, so I placed the second stencil on top of my panel and used the white ink again to add more leaves. And after that coat of white, I first thought of using my blue inks as well, but I kept this layer only white to add some variation to my background. So here's the left side of my panel, all done. I did the right side of screen and then moved on to the flowers and leaves and also the flamingo silhouettes. And as you can see, I cut all the pieces out of colored cardstocks. And to add a bit more interest, I also cut the flowers a second time out of vellum. I recently shared 2 cards that were created with die cuts only, die cuts that I colored using alcohol markers. It was the spring bunny in a basket and the peacock shaking his tail feathers. Well, this time I decided to use my oxide inks to add shadows to my elements, but it's just a personal preference. You definitely could keep the elements all plain without adding ink. So next I gathered all my elements. I used liquid glue and foam squares to assemble everything, and I didn't want my flowers and leaves to be flat on my panel. So I tried to give dimension to some pieces just by using my glue tube or my fingers. Once everything was attached, you know me, I always like to add splatters on my projects. Any kind of splatters, water or ink. For this card, I went with white acrylic paint only to add light and make the elements pop even more. So I just mixed a knob of white paint with water and used a small brush to create a bunch of splatters all over my panel. Off screen, I cut the word Aloha out of wood grain cardstock and mermaid cardstock. I applied a bit of vintage photo on the edges of my wood textured word and glued it on the mermaid element. And I attached my word below the flowers. Next, I attached my panel on a mermaid card base. And finally, I added clear droplets in the center of each flower and a few more here and there to bring some shine to my project. And this is the final result, a super bright and colorful card that I hope will give you some tropical and Hawaiian vibes. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Have a nice day. Bye.